Hi, my name's Stephen Hartley. I live in Banbury in the UK, between London and Birmingham. And this video is called God School, which I established yesterday, godschool.uk. And this is an introductory video for those who are interested in attaining oneness with God, or at least, if not going that far, at least improving your soul and your life as part of that. Okay, first of all, I'd like to thank God, as I feel I have his backing on the, or his and her backing on this, and it may well be part of God's plan to get everybody in a better state. So thank you very much, God, for that. I'd also like to thank, and I would say I would never have got to this if it weren't for AJ Miller, who's got the Divine Truth channel on YouTube. And he's proclaims that he was Jesus in the first century, and I believe him. I'd also like to thank my supplier of a special herb, which I believe is a way to attain this oneness with God quicker and easier than if you were to not use it. But it can't just be used all the time, that wouldn't work. I want to just give you a very brief rundown of my life. I have a Norwegian mother and an English father, who, my English father, I think he's got some Indian blood in him. Never proved, but I'm pretty sure that his mother's father was full on Indian, if not half Indian. I was born in Maidstone, Kent, where we quite soon moved up to Cheshire, and then by the time I was one or two, we moved to Richmond in North Yorkshire, where I lived until I was five, and then moved to Bodicote, just south of Banbury, basically touching Banbury. And I lived there until I was about 19, 20, and I went off to live in Norway for a few years and then came back to Banbury, not willingly, but ended up in Banbury, where I've lived for all that, up to now. Now I'm now 37. I have a son who's 7 years old. I was married briefly for a couple of years when I had my son. But I've been single for 7 years, and in that time I've been smoking a lot of cannabis, which was my main drug of choice. I also smoke tobacco, I drink tea and a bit of coffee, and I like chocolate and sugar. I'm quite active, but I don't have a TV. I use my laptop for my entertainment, and to make my money, I've been fixing computers for the last, 12 years, self-employed, which has given me, since the recession anyway, has given me lots of spare time to find what I wanted to do or find the truth. And about, and about a couple of months ago, or 3 months ago, just before I went on holiday, I really got onto this new truth, this new path. Okay, so I just want to say that what I'm about to demonstrate, you must have the correct truths in your soul. And to get the truths in your soul, you need to really understand those truths. So if I just tell you God is an actual being, an entity made up of, like our soul is, of half male and half female, although some souls are half male and half male, and some souls are half female and half female, most of them are half male and half female. So if I just tell you that, you know, you can't just then say, okay, now I know the truth. You have to really think through what that means. So, you know, a big part of that means that you are only half a soul, and that the other half of your soul is out there somewhere. Maybe you've met them, maybe you haven't, maybe you're with them, maybe you're not. So important to get these truths in your soul fully. And the next part of this is, I'm using a good quality natural cannabis, just the flower, no, none of the leaves. And I say it's a natural cannabis, that is my preference. It might work with the other skunky type cannabises, but it might not work so well. And you have to have had, you know, at least a 9-day break without any cannabis. So if a lot of people who use cannabis all the time, which I would have included myself a few months ago, it just doesn't work. Okay. Yeah, so I kind of got onto this new path 2 or 3 days before I went on holiday. And something was leading me towards the path a couple of months before that, or you could say my whole life. And, during my life, I have always been a believer in God. But, you know, that belief in what God was did change a bit during my life. Obviously, it started out with what I learned at school. And then I read the Bible, the New Testament, the Old Testament. I read the Quran. And, you know, all of these putting together my idea of God. And then I got onto this sort of New Age thing, which I think I was probably fed this by a spirit, that we're all God. And that wasn't the truth. So, yes. So, 2 days before I went on holiday in August, so that was something like the 12th of 13th of August, something like that, I stumbled onto some of these new truths. And since then, I then went on holiday, continued my life as normal, but started to let these truths in. Then I was watching more of the information from AJ Miller on the Divine Truth channel, and decided I needed to give up cannabis because I wasn't getting my dreams. And I knew that from previous times when I'd gone a few days without cannabis, that dreams came back to me, but I quite quickly got back on the cannabis and lost the dreams again. I was okay with that because I just thought, well, I do get the odd dream, so if there was anything very important, it will get to me. But I really wasn't clear on what my sleep state was. And to know your sleep state is quite important, because that's how you know your true soul state, if you like. Because in the sleep state you go into the spiritual spheres, and you can only go as high as your soul state will permit. If you've got issues, whatever, you cannot go higher than those issues permit. So I gave up cannabis and I thought, you know, I'll just give it up. And it'd been about sort of 10 days without any cannabis. And my dad had actually died from cancer, from the treatments of cancer. And then at his funeral, we gave him a good send-off. We had a very good party. Lots of people came. It was a very happy occasion. And there was some cannabis there in that evening, and I partook, and I noticed how high I got from both from having the new truths in me that were correct, and also from having a spell without cannabis. I've been able to get my dreams and understand a bit about what's going on. And I actually believe at that point I was spiritually born again. I had a very, very high moment, and that's what it felt like. So whether I was or not at that point, I don't know, but that's what it felt like. So then I went another couple of weeks without cannabis, and I thought, I actually want to try and do this again. I want to smoke some cannabis and get to this high point and see if I can actually tap into some of the emotions I'm finding it hard to feel. Because from the teachings of A.J. Miller, when we're born, we start getting this emotional damage to our soul from our parents, and even generational ones, because it's been passed on to our parents and from their parents and so on. So feeling these emotions is key to actually repairing your soul, if you like. And so I 2 weeks ago, I smoked cannabis again. So this is for the second time since I'd given up. And it was quite amazing, some of the things that I was feeling. And I was with people a lot of the time, so I was doing a lot of talking and sharing and everything. But at one point I was on my own, and I really tapped into some of the things I'd done in my younger childhood, which were errors. And what I noticed then is, as I was coming off the cannabis, I was actually in a better state than I was 2 weeks previously coming off the cannabis. It still isn't pleasant coming off the cannabis, coming down. But because it also takes quite a long time to come down. I could really feel that. I'd smoke a cannabis joint, go up quite quickly, up, I'd say, a good 4 or 5 levels. So if I was on level 1 or 2 at that point, you know, I would actually go up to sort of level 6 or 7. And I also really felt God closely, and for the first time really felt the female attributes, the female half of God, which I had been struggling with feeling before. As I guess all my life I'd just been thinking, well, I was thinking God was a man. I knew he was more than that. I knew it was more than that, but I didn't actually see it in that way of male and female. And then coming down again, you know, not particularly pleasant, but because you come down quite slowly. So say after an hour I came down one level, and I feel that it's not significant, but it feels a bit like an unpleasant deja vu. But you're still on a high sphere, so you're still feeling high. And then after a day, probably come down another level. And then after about a week, I'd say, come down to my standard state, or even drop down just a state lower than the standard state. And then the next day, back to your normal state. And that's, you know, you're getting your normal dreams and everything else. Now this time, I've been feeling really good. Now, I haven't done it enough times to be absolutely sure what's going on. Whether there's cannabis in the air and I'm breathing some of that in, that's possible. But what I think really I tapped into, I wrote down all the things I'm addicted to. Now, for me, most of these are physical addictions because I spend a lot of time on my own. So they're not so much things I get other people to do or lean on other people. They're more about what my physical addictions. But also, you know, wanting sex is, you know, every time I see a good-looking woman, you know, that would come into my mind. And See, every addiction covers a fear that you have. And when I wrote down the fears next to these addictions, most of them were fear of being unloved. And that is probably something we all have, because we all have this this hole where God should be. Not when we're born, because we're still connected to God, but from our parents and from their generations and the generations before, all the way back to the first people on this earth. That's another truth we'll get into later or in another video. I was just thinking to myself all the time, I don't need that, because I am loved. God loves me all the time, as he loves everybody all the time. And that I think that was what made a significant improvement. So this is while I'm in a normal state. And my dreams over the past few nights, I've been in better and better places. I remember all of my dreams, so it shouldn't be getting high from anything else, otherwise I wouldn't remember my dreams. So I'm very, very pleased about that, and I seem to be progressing quite well. I was almost a little bit sort of unsure whether I should have any cannabis this time, because maybe I should now just do it on my own. And I think after this weekend, I should go for a whole month without cannabis, and hopefully I'll be not needing any at all. I don't necessarily need it, but I want to see if this really does help progress the repairing, if you like, of the soul quicker. Because what I noticed was, when you're high, you can recognize things. You're in a higher state, so you can recognize issues you've got. You can feel God much more strongly, and so what I'm about to do, and I actually believe now I think I'm in a sort of a sphere state level 3, which is also one where you can't lie when you're in level 3, and I don't feel any desire to lie. I want to be honest. Perhaps if a policeman came up to me, I might not tell him the whole truth, but so not quite sure what's going to happen. I just make a point of, you don't really have to intellectually decide what issue you're going to deal with next. They kind of come naturally. God has made everything so that you just deal with what comes up. So I'm going to smoke a cannabis joint. I'm going to go up levels reasonably quickly. I've made this first one quite weak so that I don't completely blow my head off. And I'm probably going to turn the video camera off, because I don't want to be distracted by it, and then I might turn it on again and see, because you wouldn't necessarily see how I feel, right? You might see a big smile across my face, but it's not actually going to tell you anything. So I'm going to turn it off now. Okay.